So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. In today's session, as usually guys, we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are important, which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and above. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group for updated information regarding the daily sessions and also regarding the courses. Now let's talk about the very first question, which says a joint communication was signed between MOEFCC, which means Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, and Ministry of Travel Affairs. So question is, what is the purpose? Now you have to tell me who is the Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change after the cabinet reshuffling, and who is the Minister of Travel Affairs. कैबिनेट एक्सपेंशन का एक पूरा का पूरा वीडियो मैंने बनाया था, अगर आपने नहीं देखा है तो प्लीज जल्दी जाके देखो, एनडीए 2.0 कैबिनेट एक्सपेंशन करके थंबनेल पे है, उसकी हेडिंग है. सो नाउ यू हैव टू टेल मी हु इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ एनवायरमेंट, फॉरेस्ट एंड क्लाइमेट चेंज एंड द मिनिस्टर ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स. सो द क्वेश्चन इज, व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ दिस जॉइंट कम्युनिकेशन. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस न्यूज गाइज. सो रिमेंबर, अ जॉइंट कम्युनिकेशन वॉज साइंड बिटवीन दीज टू मिनिस्ट्रीज, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स एंड द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरमेंट. Now this joint communication has been signed to give more powers to the tribal communities in managing their own forest resources. जो forest resources हैं उनको manage करने के लिए tribal communities को और ज़्यादा powers दी जाएंगी through this joint communication. Also remember that this joint communication is aimed at effective implementation of the Forest Rights Act of 2006. जो Forest Rights Act है 2006 का, उसका effective implementation भी इसका एक objective है. And also for harnessing the potential of livelihood improvement of the forest dwelling scheduled tribes and also the other traditional forest dwellers. Okay, so basically जो forest dwelling scheduled tribes हैं और जो traditional forest dwellers हैं उनकी livelihood improvement पे भी focus किया जाएगा through this joint communication that was signed between these two ministries. Now what is the significance of this joint communication? इससे होगा क्या, क्या significance है, क्यों किया है? तो इसका सबसे बड़ा सिग्निफिकेंस गाइस तो ये है कि फ्रॉम नाउ ट्राइबल्स एंड अदर फॉरेस्ट ड्वेलर्स दे कैन आल्सो कंट्रीब्यूट इन द एफर्ट्स टुवर्ड्स क्लाइमेट चेंज. वो क्लाइमेट चेंज में जो हमारा देश एफर्ट डाल रहा है उसमें ये कंट्रीब्यूशन कर सकते हैं. कैसे कर सकते हैं? थ्रू द प्रिजर्वेशन ऑफ बायोडाइवर्सिटी, एनवायरमेंटल कंजर्वेशन एंड इनहांसिंग द फॉरेस्ट कवर. हाउ दे कैन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टुवर्ड्स द एफर्ट्स इन द क्लाइमेट चेंज? By preservation of biodiversity, by environmental conservation, and also by enhancing the forest cover. And other than this, this joint communication will work towards the welfare of the scheduled tribes and other traditional forest dwellers also. So this is the significance of this joint communication, and that's it about this news. Now let's come back to the question. So what is the purpose? For harnessing the potential for livelihood improvement. Yes, this is absolutely correct. For effective implementation of the Forest Rights Act of 2006, this is also correct. And for the benefit of forest conservation of biodiversity, conservation and biodiversity. So all the statements are guys absolutely correct. Option D should be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. Who inaugurated the online filing of authorized economic operators application AEO T2 and T3? Now what is this authorized economic operators application? Iski bhi hum baat karenge. So remember, the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs, that is headed by Mr. M. Ajit Kumar. M. Ajit Kumar is the chairperson of Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs, CBIC. And for direct taxes, we have another body which is known as CBDT, Central Board of Direct Taxes. Now you have to tell me who is the chairperson of this? Who is the chairperson of this? जो इनके chairman है, उन्होंने कुछ time पहले ही उनका जो कार्यकाल था वो खत्म हुआ है. Now who is the new chairperson? You have to write down in the comments. So CBIC has inaugurated the online filing of authorized economic operators application AEO T2 and T3. Now this program is designed to ensure continuous real time and digital monitoring of the physically filed AEO T2 and T3 application. जो AEO यानी कि authorized economic operators T2 और T3 level की जो applications होती है उनकी real time और digital monitoring की जाएगी through this program. Now let's talk about what is this AEO program. So remember, AEO, this program was launched in the year 2007 by World Customs Organization SAFE framework, and this is basically under this framework, which is World Customs Organization SAFE framework, and SAFE stands for Standards to Secure and Facilitate Global Trade. And also remember, World Customs Organization is headquartered in Brussels, which is in Belgium. Okay. Remember, this program aims to enhance the international supply chain security. So what is the objective of this program? To enhance the international supply chain security and also to facilitate the movement of legitimate goods. Basically, to identify which traders are secure and which traders are not. Okay. So what will happen and what happens under this is that under this framework, under this program, any entity which is engaged in international trade is approved by World Customs Organization as a compliant with supply chain security standard. मतलब World Customs Organization इसमें क्या करता है, approval देता है exporters को, जो international traders होते हैं उनको, कि वो उनका जो product है या उनकी जो पूरी trading है वो compliant है किसके साथ, supply chain security standards and granted the AEO status then. So any entity with AEO status is considered a secure trader. As I told you, it decides which trader are secure and which are not. And remember, it is a voluntary program. ऐसा जरूरी नहीं है कि हर किसी को AEO का status लेना है, हर exporter को या हर international trader को, ऐसा कोई जरूरी नहीं है. Okay? Now talking about the Indian AEO program. So India में AEO program as a pilot launch हुआ था in the year 2011. And currently it has a membership of about 5,000 AEO entities. So basically ये voluntary यहाँ पे भी नहीं है, but यहाँ पे होता ही है कि जो international traders होते हैं उनको एक secure trader जब हम declare कर देंगे या कोई भी एक बड़ी organization उसको secure trader declare कर देगा तो उनके लिए एक benefit होगा, क्योंकि बाहर से जो लोग उनसे सामान मंगवाएंगे उनके लिए safe and secure होगा. Okay? And this Indian AEO program is based on WCO, World Customs Organization, same framework only. And there are three tier AEO status in India for exporters and importers, which are AEO tier 1, tier 2 and tier 3. Now we don't have to go in deep about these tiers. Just remember that AEO tier 3, T3 is the highest level of accreditation. Then we have T2 and the lowest one is AEO tier 1. Okay. So guys, this was about this news and now let's come back to the question. The correct answer is what? The Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs. Option B will be the correct answer. And moving ahead to question number 3. Which organization has created world's first database of genomic variant DB Genvoc for the oral cancer? Oral cancer ke liye world ka pehla database bana hai genomic variant ka, jiska naam hai DB Genvoc. To kisne banaya hai? So remember, the world's first database of genomic variants of oral cancer has been made and it is named as DB Genvoc. And remember, it has been made by Department of Biotechnology's body, which is known as National Institute of Biomedical Genomics, which is located in Kalyani. And Kalyani is a place in West Bengal, do remember this. And this has been done, guys, to support advances in the oral cancer research. Now, these are some basic information about the DB Genvoc. These are not important for the exam. This is just for the basic understanding. Like, it is a browsable online database of genomic variants of oral cancer. It will be a free resource and it will be publicly accessible. And remember, it is not just a catalog of genomic variants. It has a built-in powerful search engine also. It will allow a reasonable extent of statistical and bioinformatic analysis to be carried out online. So these are some of the basic information. Just remember the name DB Genvoc and which organization has made this. National Institute of Biomedical Genomics. So therefore, the correct answer should be what? National Institute, okay, none of these, option E, none of these would be the correct answer because that is not in the option. National Institute of Biomedical Genomics, which is located in Kalyani in West Bengal. So now let's talk about the question number 4, which is the last question for today. Remember guys, this question is more important for NABARD. Ye NABARD ke liye zyada important hai, RBI mein iska zyada importance nahi hai, but yes, phase 1 mein pucha ja sakta hai. So the very first shipment of GI certified Bhalia variety of wheat was exported to Kenya and Sri Lanka from Gujarat. Bhalia wheat belongs to Dash. So answer यहीं पे आ गया है गलती से. Alright, Gujarat से इसको export किया गया है. And the correct answer also to this question is what? Gujarat. Okay, so ये जो Bhalia wheat है ये कहाँ से belong करती है? Gujarat से. But never mind, let's discuss the news. So the news is that the first shipment of GI tagged Bhalia variety of wheat was exported to Kenya and Sri Lanka from Gujarat. And remember, it is grown mostly across the Bhal region of Gujarat. Okay, Bhal region hai Gujarat mein, wahan pe isko ugaya jata hai, which includes Ahmedabad, Anand, Kheda, Bhavnagar, Surendranagar, Bharuch. This initiative is expected to give a boost to the wheat exports from India. And remember, दिस वीट हैज अ वेरी हाई प्रोटीन कंटेंट एंड इट्स टेस्ट इज समवॉट स्वीट, थोड़ा थोड़ा मीठा मीठा सा ये, ओके. एंड इट इज ग्रोन इन रेन फेड कंडीशन विदाउट इरीगेशन एंड कल्टिवेटेड इन अराउंड 2 lakh hectares ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल लैंड इन द स्टेट ऑफ गुजरात. एंड इसके पास GI सर्टिफिकेशन है 2011 से, ओके. सो ये जो न्यूज है इसमें पूछा क्या क्या जा सकता है. सबसे पहला सवाल तो ये है कि भालिया वीट कहाँ से बिलोंग करता है. दूसरा सवाल ये है कि क्या इसके पास GI टैग है या नहीं, GI टैग के फॉर्म में भी पूछा जा सकता है. तीसरा ये कि कौन से रीजन में उगाया जा सकता है गुजरात के, ओके. सो देयरफॉर गाइस द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट ऑप्शन ए गुजरात एंड गुजरात चीफ मिनिस्टर इज मिस्टर विजय रूपानी. सो गाइस दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन टुडे. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.